Welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn how to implement Spring retry in our Spring Boot application without using any custom logic for retry. For example, if we are going to fetch data from third party API or we are going to create connection with database, but due to some issue we are not able to connect with database or not able to fetch the data from third party API, then in this case we can perform retry operation. Okay, let's go to the code and check how we can implement retry in our Spring Boot application. So here I have already created one Spring Boot application, and inside this class we have only just one single class, that is Spring Boot main class with the annotation @ Spring Boot application. And inside pom.xml I have just added Spring Web dependency only. So Spring Starter Web dependency I have added only here. So okay, let's go to here and we'll create one controller class and we'll create one API. So here I will create message controller, and at this class we need to define annotation @restcontroller, so Spring Boot application will understand, and we create the bean for this class. And here I will just define one REST endpoint by using get mapping annotation, and here I will define the URL path for this API, and here I will just return one string message, public string get message return message. So here we can type message received successfully. So here I have created one REST endpoint, and this endpoint will return this string message. So let's start our application and test this API. So now I will run as Java application, but before that I need to add Logger here. Logger is equal to Logger factory dot get Logger. So here I will use Cell4j libraries, and here we need to pass message controller as a parameter. So here we need to import Cell4j library. So here we can print the logs inside our controller method, logger.info inside message controller get message method. So let's start our application and test our REST point if it is working or not. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080, and here I will just type localhost message. So here we can see the response received successfully, and inside logs we can check also the logs. Here we can see inside message controller get a message method was executed. And now there is a requirement, we need to fetch the data from third party API. So we need to call third party API, but we will do REST template, and RT is equal to new REST template. And here we need to call rt.get4object method, and here we need to pass the URL from which API we want to get the data, localhost 9090 demo. But we have not created this REST endpoint, and this REST endpoint is not active, so it will fail every time. So here I will call object.class. So if I will call this REST endpoint now, so we will not get this response because This method will fail every time here when it will call to this URL. If here I will pass valid URL, it may be fail due to some time connection issue, or we need to retry again. But if we can go with Spring retry, then it will automatically handle everything. Okay, let's try with this endpoint. We will stop the application and run this as Java application. So here we can see our application has started port number 8080. Now we will refresh this endpoint, and here we can see we are not getting any response. And inside logs we can check inside message controller get message method was executed. So let's look how to enable retry operation in our Spring Boot application. So to enable retry in our REST endpoint, we need to add two Maven dependencies. So here I will add two Maven dependencies. So here we need to add these two Maven dependencies here. One is Spring Boot retry and second is Spring aspect. These two Maven dependencies we need to add. So we have added these dependencies. Now I will go to our main class. And here we need to add annotation @enableRetry. So this annotation we can add in our main class or at our configuration class also. So now enable retry is applicable in our Spring Boot application. Now I will go to our message controller class. So these are the three main annotations that we will use in Spring retry annotations. One is @enableRetry annotation. @enableRetry annotation means that we can apply at our configuration class or we can apply at our main class. So it will enable the retry operation for our application. And second annotation is retryable. So this annotation we can use at class level or at method level. If you will use this annotation at class level, then it will applicable for all the methods. Otherwise, we can use this annotation at method level also. And third annotation is recover annotation. So this annotation we can use when our max retry attempt failed again and again and reached up to its threshold limit, then we can use this @recover annotation. So here we can define our recovery logic. So okay, let's see in the code how we can implement. So here I will use this annotation @retryable. So here I have defined this annotation at method level. So this annotation will be applicable only for get message method. And by default, this annotation will perform retry operation only for 3 times and delay with 1 second. So after every 1 second, it will call 3 times only. So okay, we can call this API and can check how many times it will execute this method. And here we can declare int I is equal to 0, and here we can define plus plus I. Okay, let's call this endpoint and we'll check how many times it's calling by default. How many times it will perform retry operation, so we can check. So here I have started our application. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So first I will clear the logs. Now I will go to browser and refresh and call to this endpoint. So here we can see in the logs. Here it is the first call inside message controller get message method, and this is the second call inside message controller get message method, and this is a third call. After that it was failed again. So like this annotation can perform retry operation for 3 times default value, and we can make it is a customizable and we can increase the number of retry also by using max attempt variables. So if I will use max attempts is equal to 5, then it will perform 5 time retry operation if the application getting failed, this logic is getting failed. So let stop this application and start the server again. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. So first I will clear the logs. Now I will go to browser and refresh the same endpoint. So here we can see first, second, third, and it will perform retry operation for 5 times. So first call inside this method, second, third, four, 5 time. And by default it perform retry operation after every 1 second. But if you want to increase delay time between the each call, then we can use back off. So here we can use back off. So it will increase the time between each call. So here we can use annotation @backoff. And here we need to define the attribute delay is equal to 2000, means 2 seconds. And here we can define two attribute, int last call time is equal to 0l, int, or we can define long time difference is equal to 0l. So here we can calculate the time difference like this. Time difference is equal to system dot current time in milliseconds minus last time call, and here we can calculate the last time system dot current time in milliseconds. And we can print this time in logs, time difference here. So okay, let's stop our application and start it again. So here we can see our application has started at port number 8080. Let's clear the logs and retry operation, and we'll call the same endpoint localhost 8080 message, and here we can see the response and logs are getting printed, and here we can see the time difference between each log. So first call, second call, third call, fourth call. So for every call there is 2 second difference. So we can just put this element, this line above the logger. So like there are multiple retryable parameter that we can use for this annotation @retryable. If we want to increase time by multiplier of 2000, then we can use here multiplier variable. There is multiplier variable parameter is also available. So here I have added multiplier is equal to 2. Now delay will increase 2 times after every retry. So first call if we will take 2 seconds, in second call it will take 4 seconds, and for third call it will take 8 seconds. So it will increase the delay time for every call. So let's start our application and check the logs. So let's clear the logs. Our application has started. Now we will retry. So let's check the logs. So here we can see first call, second call, 2 second difference. After third call, 4 second. So it will multiply 4 into 2, 8 second. And next call will be after 16 second. So 8 into 2 will be 16. So like this we can increase the delay time between each call by using retryable. multiplier attribute. So now here we can see there is 16 second difference. And here one more annotation is at the rate recover annotation that we can also use. It might happen after all the retry method does not successfully completed. So in that case we can use at the rate recover annotation, because here we can see after 5 retry it was not completed successfully and we did not get any response in our API after 5 attempts. So here we can use at the rate recover annotation also. So here we can define public string get recovery message, recovery logic here. So if our method is getting again and again and reached up to max attempts, then it will call to this method. So here we will just return recovery message as the output. So let's call our API again and we'll check if it is executing this method or not. So let's run our application again. So here we can see our application has started and now I will clear the logs. Now we will go to browser and refresh and go to the same rest endpoint. So here we have already applied multiplier by 2, so it will take more time for each call, it will multiply by 2. So there are 4 retries already completed. Now it will call 5th time, and if 5th time it's also getting failed, then we will get a recovery message. That is the method. So it's failed 5 times. Now we will go to browser and here we can see we are getting a recovery message was executed successfully. So like this we can use at the rate recover annotation. So here we can also add the logs inside get recovery message. So this was about how to perform retry in our Spring Boot application by using retryable annotation. Thanks for watching this video.